Science, technology and social change. Who spoke about science? Rise of science is what is social change. August Comte. Who spoke about science and technology as an instrument of social change? Emile Durkheim spoke about when he says increasing division of labor, organic solidarity. Then again, who spoke about the role of science for social change? Role of science in social change. Role of science in social change. Karl Marx, FOP. Advancement of FOP is what? Science and technology. So science and technology keeps on growing. But what is not going to change? ROP will not change. And that improvement of FOP will compel ROP to change, and ROP change will be revolutionary change. So Marx also spoke about the role of science and technology in social change when he writes about the improvisation or the inherent dynamic nature of forces of production. Then, Ogburn speaks about science and technology as agents of social change. He says, discovery, invention and diffusion are the processes involved in science, technology becoming agents of social change. So using these three processes, invention, discovery and thirdly diffusion, William Ogburn writes about the role of science and technology in causing social change. Right? What do you mean by discovery? A new thing which was present already, for the first time it was identified. For example, discovery of America. By who? Who discovered America? Columbus. Already America was present, but this was discovered. So already present reality was identified for the first time. And that is called as discovery. So science and technology helps in discovery. Science and technology helps in invention. Invention means modification of what is already present. Invention is modification of what is already present. Invention is modification of what is already present. Right? So that is what is invention. Something new to the old is what is invention. Third is diffusion. So the science and technology, the products of science and technology will get diffused from one place to another place. Like a computer came from America to India. This is what is diffusion. Right? Ogburn speaks about how science and technology can produce changes only in the material culture. Science and technology can produce changes in the material culture, not in the non-material culture. So the change in the material culture may be fast in comparison to change in the non-material culture, and that results in what? Cultural lag. Cultural lag is leading to conflict. Cultural lag leads to conflict. Cultural lag is leading to conflict. So, M.N. Srinivas rightly points out that Indian society is not becoming modern like that of the Western counterpart. We are Sanskritized, so as Westernized. Sanskritization speaks about the reinforcement of the hierarchy. Westernization speaks about acceptance of the material culture. So, Sanskritization, Westernization concept speaks about how, on one hand, we can accept the technological implements or the products of science and technology. At the same time, we are also reinforcing the hierarchy. So, there are contesting relationships which may emerge in the contemporary times because of the uneven changes in the material and the non-material culture. So, reinforcement of inequality, at the same time, science and technology gives opportunity for eradicating diseases which were killing the population before. So, new inventions, diffusions, on one hand is going to create a cult of security because most of the diseases has been cured today with the advancement in science and technology. At the same time, it also creates something called as a risk society, as Ulrich Beck says, that it creates anxiety. Internet revolution is also followed by cyber crimes. So, the changes brought forward by science and technology may not be comprehensive. It may be partial in some places, it may be complete in some places, and it may be leading to contradiction in some other places. Right? Rise of industrial society itself is an instrument of, is a product of growth of science and technology. So, studying the changes present in the society with the advent of science and technology is what is studying a modern society, and that becomes the subject matter of sociology. In essence, sociology only studies how a new society came with the appearance of, with the modernization of technological implements, with the revolution of industrial economy, with more and more science and technology entering the society, a new modern society came, a new factory system came, new class relation came, urbanization came, and a cult of modernity came, and to study this modern society only came sociology. So, studying the impact of science and technology in society is nothing but the subject matter of sociology. Right from the evolutionary theorist till the contemporary scholars, they have spoken about how new technology affects the institutions, the social institutions. With the coming of surrogacy, family is undergoing changes. With the coming of IT revolution, kinship, inheritance, and other types of social relationship has undergone changes. So, study of a new society, which is an outcome of science and technology, is what is study of modern society or sociology.